Now that we know what dynamic input is, let's talk about some settings that we can change in the drafting settings. So to get to the drafting settings, really there's lots of ways that you can get to it. Any one of these little pull down arrows, when we go to snap settings or anything, it pulls up the same window as the drafting settings. So there's grid and snap, polar tracking, here's object snaps. We're gonna go to dynamic input. And I just wanna talk about the different options that we have available to us. So we have this option here, enable pointer input. So we can go into the settings if we'd like. By default, it's going to go into the polar format. So when we started it, remember it was prompting us for an angle instead of an X and Y value. And by default, it's going to go and do a relative coordinate instead of an absolute coordinate. So these are just the basic settings. You could change that if you want to, but those are the basic settings that it comes with. And visibility, as soon as you show that tooltips, those little words and where it's prompting you, when a command asks for a prompt. So if something's talking to me at the command line, I'm going to get a prompt right there at the cursor as well. So I'll say okay to that. And then here, we're going to check that box, enable dimension input where possible. I'll go to my settings. And this is where it's got several different options. We always just leave these at the default. I just want to show you where they are. But it says show two dimension input fields at a time. So I'll say okay to that. That's a default there. And then we have these options right here. So show the command prompt at command prompting and command input near the crosshairs, which is what it's doing right where my crosshair is. It's showing it right there. And then show additional tips with command prompting. So I get more options. So, you know, if I need to go into deeper settings, it'll actually usually offer me that. I can change what my tooltip appearance looks like. So this is nice if you need to have bigger sizes, you can actually set them to be bigger. If you like things to be a lot bigger on your screen, you can do that, or smaller, you can go either way. You can also set the transparency. So if you want them to kind of fade off into the background, then you could have it do that as well. So we'll just say okay to this and okay to this, and that's it. That's how you change your drafting settings.